Jesus is the answer.
The LCCG Tabernacle of David, House of Favor, through the grace of God, has grown from a 7-member house fellowship to a church without walls, with over 2,000 members, 32 house fellowships, and 4 church plants. Tabernacle of David, also known as TOD, is a church stronger through worship, warmer through friendship, deeper through discipleship, broader through ministry, and larger through evangelism.
Tabernacle of David is a church that is passionate about God. It's a youthful church. We love to worship God, and we are prayer warriors. That's who we are.
The journey of grace for Tabernacle of David started on the 8th of May 2005, when it was established as a full-fledged church by the RCCG City of David under the leadership of Pastor Escor Umfong of blessed memory. Pastor Femi Monain, TOD's pioneer pastor, was the leader of Tabernacle of David's House Fellowship, which started with 7 members. On the 8th of May 2005, the RCCG Tabernacle of David held its first service at the Brick House at Kilometer 20, Lekki Ekpe Expressway, Lagos. The Lord led Pastor Monahi to purchase the land on which the church is now built at Kilometer 22, Lekki Ekpe Expressway, and by June 2007, Tabernacle of David held its first service at the present location. Pastor Monet served faithfully, and the church grew both spiritually and in membership. In September 2010, Pastor Monet resigned as pastor of the Tabernacle of David's church. October 2010, Pastor Kaya Depiton was posted to Tabernacle of David to lead the church in a period the church was passing through some challenges.
I came here after 4 years that this church had been set up. The structures had been put in place. There was a culture that I met on ground. I met here people who were willing to work. I call them the remnant, you know, people that love God. I was well received.
When Pastor Kayode resumed at TOD, construction of the administrative building was near completion. Foundation work of the church auditorium was in progress, and services were being held in a tent on the church grounds. Many TOD members who had made pledges towards the building projects had left the church.
When I came in, like for instance, this auditorium where we are meeting today was not there. It was just the ground. It was on foundation level, you know. The pledges, you know, that were made for the building fund, there was nothing because the people had left the church, most of those that made pledges. So I had to start, you know, with a new set of people who didn't know me. I had to raise new pledges. In fact, I remember the first meeting I had, and I was talking about the building project. I mentioned the fact that as the Lord liveth, we're going to do this. As the Lord liveth, we're going to do this. So many times that on my way home, my wife asked me, do you have some fund that you had kept somewhere, you know, that you're going to use, you know, for these projects? I said, no. Said, because with the fervency and the way you said, as the Lord liveth, I felt there was something that, you know, you knew I didn't know, you know. But God has been very faithful, you know. All of the things I said, God had allowed them to come to pass.
With God's grace in abundance and Pastor Coyote's open and transparent leadership, he quickly built trust and gained members' cooperation in moving the building project forward with speed.
When I came, the admin building, you know, was on ground, you know, about to be completed, you know. So basically what I did was, we completed the admin building, we equipped it and furnished it. Basically, we built the auditorium from the ground and the lighthouse. Like, we have spent millions upon millions of naira. we had to raise all of the funds. But other things helped us. One, it was the grace of God. Secondly, I met plans on the ground that the former pastor, was implementing faithfully before he left. To save time, and to make sure that we didn't lose speed, I didn't change the plans. Because if you did that, you had to go back for new approvals. So I looked at what was on ground. It was good. So I said, look, I will just go ahead and implement what I met on the ground.
Today, the mighty move of God is evident in TOD. Under Pastor Kayode's godly inspired leadership, the School of Disciples, Bookshop, Upgraded Content Multimedia Department, and TOD TV were all quickly established. New cutting edge ministry initiatives have also been developed, like TOD apps, websites, social media platforms, and so much more, to fully establish TOD as an e-church.
One of our vision is to have a church without walls. Secondly, some of our members are professionals. They travel a lot. So the idea of being an e-church was that even if you were not in church, you were outside the country, you could be part of the service. Secondly, we could actually have church with those who are not our members, who are outside TUD. It's a tool of evangelism for us. So on Sundays now, when service is going on, we have people who are part of the service in Australia, in Dubai, different parts of the world. Most of our members are young and they have smartphones. And we are saying you can do a lot of things with your smartphones. So we had a TOD apps. With the TOD apps, you can actually pay your tithes, you can watch services, you can archive what we have done, it has helped a lot. We now have members of TOD who don't come here physically, and it's a great tool for evangelism.
TOD has established four churches: the Seed of David, Great Joy, City of Zoe, Temple of Praise, and has churches in Burundi and Ghana.
The first church we planted was Seed of David. We felt the youth must be encouraged, and they are doing very well. So we are very strong when it comes to house fellowships. At a point, we had over 40 house fellowships. And some of these house fellowships, they had grown, which means the people that were managing them are basically pastors in training. We had two house fellowships that had close to 100 members each. So we felt we should allow these two house fellowships to become parishes. So that was why we made City of Zoe and Greater Joy house fellowships to become parishes. And then we had an opportunity in Ibrahim Adesanya, when one of the schools, Greater Scholar School, opened up the place for us. So we set up Temple of Praise. So in the last 4 years, we have set up four parishes. There's another parish now in Bulgaria. They are meeting in the home of one of the elders for now. God has been good to them also. Somebody donated a plot of land. So we're waiting to get the approvals to build, in Bulgaria.
TOD has developed a reputation for her Christian social responsibility, both for congregation and community. Like the educational support scheme, vocational training, training in tiling and plumbing skills, career track, and medical outreach.
I remembered when I first got to TOD, somebody said to me that you are an Ikoyi person. Why did they post you to TOD? Some of the members have not gone to school, they're jobless, And I said to them, I was not born in Ikoyi, and that my background was humble also. Education, made me who I am. So everywhere I am, in any way I can assist, people who have children who are smart should not be denied the opportunity. Those children should not be denied education because their parents could not afford it. You know, so when I came here, you know, we established what we call the educational support scheme. Today we have about 30 students we are sponsoring, you know, up to university level. When I came in also, the people who had not gone to school, who wanted to be involved in the vocation, some who had gone to school, who could not really work with what they learned. The last one we had over 300 people that we trained. We also did another training on tiling and plumbing, you know, for people. And then for people who are working, we had the career track, you know, to help them. You're going to change your job, you want to do something, you know. Education makes all the difference.
In 2011, the administrative building was completed. February 2012, TOD Church Auditorium was dedicated to the Lord by the General Overseer, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. September 2014, Lighthouse, TOD's event and multi-purpose hall, was dedicated by Pastor Remy Morgan. And on the 1st of September 2014, Tabernacle of David, House of Favor, became RCCG Province 46 headquarters. Looking back over the past 9 years, we can truly say the Tabernacle of David has been favored by the Lord, and we are eternally grateful.
For people in TOD, my first message is thank you, thank you, and thank you. Without you, there was no way what we are witnessing today could have happened. So I am eternally grateful for your cooperation when I came with my family, for your support. I can't thank you enough. Secondly, to the parishes that have joined us, and together we form Lagos Province 46, I want to assure you that we are a province of grace and favor. Definitely, it will rub up on all of your parishes. As the Lord liveth, your parishes shall grow. As the Lord liveth, this province will be a province of favor. And for everyone that has taken time out today to be part of our joy, my prayer for all of you is that things of joy shall never cease in your homes and in your families, in the mighty name of Jesus. The good Lord that brought all of you here safely will take you home safely in Jesus' name. God bless you, and thank you very much.